is, what is self-advocacy? Okay, tell me.
Is it about self-improvement?
Along lines, yes. Anybody else?
Is it, does it have to do with representing oneself or their certain views or interests on a certain subject?
You are very new to that. Yes.
Kind of like what Abby was saying, kind of like you have to like go and like do things to like get yourself ahead, and like you don't have to, you have to like rely on yourself and not wait for other people to do things for you, but like get out there and do it yourself.
So all of these definitions are pretty much it. It's just really someone that has the capabilities or the characteristics of being able to go out there and reach for themselves, communicate with the teachers, or just communicate with anybody really, and just being able, taking the responsibility and being aware of what it takes to be successful.
Hi, it's Katie. What's up? What grade are you in? I'm a senior.
Who's your avid teacher?
Miss Inman.
Right. So I have a couple questions. How often do you talk to your teacher?
Depends. Like usually when I need help, I talk to them once a week because I want to keep my work up to grade level.
Has Avid had any influence on this?
Yeah, I think Avid has encouraged me a lot to be able to talk to my teachers because I've never really thought about going up to my teachers and talking to them how I can fix my grades, and Ms. Inman has encouraged me to do that a lot more often.
Do you find it makes a difference when you self-advocate?
Yeah, it does. I feel like the teacher thinks that you actually care about your grade. I mean, I do actually care about my grades, but it gives them a more perspective on that.
All right, thank you.
So why is self-advocacy important? Self-advocacy is important in order to understand what it takes to reach success and just to have the ability to, just to make the decisions for your own life and seem that you're also able and that nobody else really needs to make it for you.
So characteristics of self-advocacy are the ability to make choices based on preferences, interests, wants, and needs, the ability to differentiate between those wants and needs, problem solving, striving for independence while recognizing independence with others, so taking ownership of your responsibilities and doing what you can to fulfill those without the help of others, or even going and looking for the help yourself.
How it makes a tremendous difference when people self-advocate. It tells me they are concerned about their work, they're concerned about their learning, and they're not just sitting numbly by trying to skate through. A lot of times I don't know if there's a problem if they don't tell me.
So personal experiences, for example, I self-advocated with my art teacher on art projects and set up a plan with her so I could turn in art projects over the course of a week, and that really helped me catch up to where I needed to be and raise my grade.
Self-advocacy has allowed me to keep in check with my grades as well as improve my communication skills with people whom I might work with in the future. An example would be talking to my math teacher and figuring out ways to improve my grade and score really high on the final.
So how do you find that there's a difference between a kid who self-advocates for themselves, and if so, how?
Absolutely. Somebody who advocates on their own behalf really practices skills like approaching their teachers and developing those relationships, networking, asking questions. Oftentimes there are students who don't self-advocate, and they'll notice that in areas they're missing assignments, but they never go tell the teacher. And then the teacher's not aware that there was an error in areas. So I'll see the differences between students, especially when it comes to grades, when it comes to teachers having relationships with those students. But in addition to that, the college application process, advocating for yourself, getting fee waivers, getting assistance if you don't know what you're doing, those are really great opportunities to practice being your own cheerleader.
How do you differentiate self-advocating, let's say on behalf of like a parent self-advocates for their child versus a child self-advocating for themselves?
Yeah, I think in some cases parents get into the habit of advocating for their children. But in the teenage years, it's especially important for students to become independent and start practicing that themselves. On the flip side of that, there's some parents that don't feel comfortable, really don't know where to begin in terms of advocating for their child. So that student almost has to become that connection between the school and their parent. But the school has to take ownership in that as well and create opportunities for those parents to come on campus to develop those relationships so that they feel comfortable advocating for their student.
And how does Avid help instill self-advocacy within the students?
Well, first thing we do as Avid teachers is we model what that looks like. So as an Avid teacher, I advocate on behalf of my students. They see how I do that when I walk them to teachers or when I model how an email should be sent. And it's my hope that by the end of those 4 years, however long I'm with those students, that they have seen it enough that they start to feel comfortable separating from me and practicing that on their own. And then when they go off to college, they have all those tools available to them.
That's pretty much it. So what we can gather from this is just basically go out there, put yourselves, and be able to communicate. Don't wait for someone else to do it for you. Just understand that you've got to do it for yourself. Because if you remain in the same level and don't go beyond it, you won't know what could happen if you would have taken such steps.
Thank you.
Just gotta keep going.